Prematurity. I will give you a definition of prematurity. I will describe different terms that we utilize to talk about premature babies. I will give you a list of factors associated with premature labor and premature birth. And at the end, I will talk a little bit about medical conditions that occur in premature babies after birth. As a reminder, I am Dr. Wiśniewski. I am a neonatologist. And this is my YouTube channel, Neoped Edu. The only purpose of this channel is to educate you about medical conditions affecting premature babies, full-term babies, and infants up to 1 year of age. Let's get to our topic of today, prematurity. Prematurity is a situation in which we have a baby born at less than 37 weeks of gestational age, and those babies are called premature babies. When expectant mother comes to obstetrician, they give her a date, which is called a due date. And this is only one date in a calendar on which, theoretically, she's supposed to deliver full-term baby. Obviously, that almost never happens because nature has its own ways and babies are born before and after that due date. For the purpose of naming baby a full-term baby, we consider such a baby full-term when baby is born between 37 weeks and 42 weeks of gestational age. So during that span of 5 weeks, baby is called full-term baby. The small subset of those babies who are born during 37th and 38th week, we call them early-term babies. The reason for having even that small group of early-term babies is that sometimes they have mild medical problems that necessitate a little bit longer hospitalization for them rather than just 1 or 2 days that is common for normal, healthy newborn babies. If baby is born after 42 weeks of gestational age, such a baby is called post-term baby. And again, those babies sometimes have some medical problems that require them to stay in hospital for a little bit longer time. Finally, let's go back to those premature babies. So all babies born at less than 37 weeks are called premature babies. As neonatologists, we can try saving babies and providing treatment for them, starting from 23 weeks. In some countries, even we do it starting from 22 weeks. So all babies born from 22 weeks to 37 weeks will be considered premature. Obviously, the ones that were born earlier, they will be sicker. The ones that were born later will be healthier and they will not need to stay in the hospital for such a very long time. So we have different terms to describe them. The one of them is late preterm babies. So late preterm babies are defined as babies who were born between 34 weeks and 37 weeks of gestational age. The other group of babies are called extremely premature babies. Extremely premature babies are born at less than 28 weeks and usually with birth weights of less than 1,000 grams. They tend to have many more medical problems and they have to stay in the hospital usually for more than 2-3 months sometimes. And then at the end, we have that group of the smallest, tiniest, and most sick babies, and they are called micropreemies. Micropreemies are born at less than 26 weeks of gestational age, and their birth weight is usually less than 800 grams. Those babies are the sickest of all premature babies. Unfortunately, not all of them survive. Their bodies are so immature and they are so small that despite of all technology that we have in our disposal, we are not able to save all of them. I'm sure you've read in newspapers and magazines or watch on news channels information about so-called miracle babies. Those miracle babies are always those micropreemies. They were born so small and so immature that people did not expect that they would have survived. So those are happy stories, but for each happy story, we have unfortunate, sad stories that some baby did not survive. If you have any stories that you would like to share or any questions regarding prematurity, please write them down below in comment section and I will try to address those questions. Now let's get to causes or factors associated with premature labor and premature birth. After each premature birth, almost always I am asked by mothers or family members, is it anybody's fault that baby was born prematurely? And my quick, simple answer is no. It's nobody's fault. It's never anybody's fault. It's just nature decided that way. However, there are some factors associated with premature labor and birth, and we can group them into four different categories. The first one is medical problems that mother is suffering from. The second one are complications of pregnancy. The third one are demographic factors, such as age, for example. And the fourth one are behavioral factors, use of medication, substances, and so on. So as you can see, there are many different factors that can influence and perhaps lead to premature birth. But there is no one factor that can be named and we can find clear relationship between cause and final result. So those are just associations. So what are medical conditions that premature babies suffer from after birth and necessitate long hospitalization to resolve them and for babies to go home? So there is a long list, but let me give you perhaps shorter version. So the most common problems for premature babies are breathing or respiratory problems. Their lungs are very immature and many times they have breathing problems that last for a very long time during their hospital stay. The other medical problems are common infections, prolonged jaundice, feeding problems, difficulty with gaining weight, temperature instability, metabolic instabilities such as sugar problems, and finally, some more severe complications, and those could be necrosis of their bowel loops, bleeding in their brain, or maldevelopment of their eyes. So we look out for all those problems and try to address during premature baby's hospitalization. And sometimes it takes very long time for them until they resolve those issues and they can be discharged home safely with the family and parents. So in my summary, I want to emphasize that premature baby is a baby that is born at less than 37 weeks. It's a common situation in the United States because it occurs in 10 to 12% of all pregnancies. It's more common among black mothers than white mothers. There are many reasons that, or causes that might be associated with premature birth, and there are many medical conditions that affect premature babies. If you would like to learn more about those conditions, please look out for my future videos. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to write them down under comment section, and I will definitely answer those.